We are so glad to be here joining you this morning, a wonderful Sabbath day. And praise God that we arrived here safely. And it's good to be here with you as we worship and praise God. So to start our worship today, we do some songs. So the first song we're going to have is the hymn number 208, There'll Be No Dark Valley. If we all go to heaven. So no more burdens, no more sorrow, no more pain. So next hymn, we're gonna sing hymn number 476, Burdens Are Lifted at Calvary. Can we invite everybody to please stand? Thank you.
Jesus is ready.
you everyone for singing so well. You can be seated now.
Morning all.
Morning.
Nice to see so many smiley faces. Amazing. By the way, you can come to our church every week. I know it's a long way. So basically we got welcome everyone. Before I do that officially, but few announcements, few tidy things to do. Northern Church, we have a Stock the Pantry drive that we're doing, Stock the Pantry. That'll be happening on the 12th of October and the 24th of December. Stock the Pantry means that if you, church people, bring non-perishable goods, cans, you know, cans of baked beans and fruit and whatnot, spaghetti, dry stuff, bring it on the 12th of October and also the 24th of December. There'll be a big box in the foyer there for you to put your pantry stuff. This will go in aid so that Nigel and Nashing and all can distribute it, especially when we're getting closer to Christmas. There'll be a lot of needy families that we can package stuff and hand out. So, but we can't hand out if there's nothing in the larder. So please be generous. And God will bless. So that's one. Number two, as a board, we thought that we need more exposure. We need more exposure as a church to the community around us. And so the idea was brought forward that we should have t-shirts that we wear for, like, when we go for picnics or our social functions, that we should have t-shirts that promote our church, who we are. Right? So, but we are looking for a design. So church members and those children not here, the Godfrey kids are not here. But Pastor Godfrey, if you can inform them, and those adults and youth children, we need a design. So, and the design, you can call it a competition. It's not really a competition, but we want some talents. Closes on the 14th of September. So if you can give your design into any of the board members, or Cheryl or Val, your design, and then we have a board meeting. We will choose the design that we all vote would be appropriate for our church. And the person who came up with the design will have, of course, a free t-shirt to their size and a gift. Gift's always good, isn't it? So I encourage everyone to try and put a design in what you think we should promote our church, right? So it should have elements that characterizes our church. So your design should have those elements in. Right. Number three. You beautiful people who have come to visit us, welcome. Welcome church members and also our visitors. We are so privileged to have you in our church. And but members and those, we need to support this choir and church. So with the support, if you are impressed to help out the Filipino choir and church, if with any money, anything you can support them with money, see Josh. Where's Josh? Where is he? Over there. See Josh and just say, Josh, I would like to help out. All right? So you can see him during lunch or whatever and give something to help out, because we all need help. Number four, Child Protection Week, September 1st to the 7th. There is a colouring sheet on the table in the foyer for any children who wish to colour in and so on. So it's just an awareness thing that we need to protect our children. Next week is our church cleaning offering next week. And also my granddaughter Charlotte is going through some really tough times with her health. She's 15 and she's got a immune disorder that's attacking her brain, and she's really lost a lot of her faculties and she's struggling a bit. So if you could pray for her, please. Keep her in your prayers, more prayers the better. And that's our announcement. Thank you so much. Would you like to say something? Yeah. Yes.
Just on that, we are actually worshiping at the moment in a hall, rented hall in Kenwick. And so we're trying to get our own church, so we may be able to worship in a beautiful church like this one day. And at the moment, it's a little bit of a challenge for us to actually, even just acquire practice is a challenge. So where we're renting at the moment is on the upper floor. And we have quite a few not so very young members as well. So it's a little bit of a challenge going up the stairs. So any help that we can get towards our building fund, towards our own church one day, it would be really, really appreciated. So that's what the thing is for. Just want to clarify. Thank you very much.
Awesome. All right, thank you. Okay, we'll move on with the program. They have a very organized program, and so we will be well blessed today. That's it.
Thank you.
Okay, choir, please come up to sing the prayer.
Good morning, church. Happy Sabbath. So let me ask you this. How many times do you pray in a day? Why praying always? Well, you know, prayer is communication with God, and totally we depend on God. We are to communicate with Him always. We need to tell Him our joys and sorrows, plans and aspirations are all. We should not stop praying, either we are involved of being idle. We should not stop praying either, are involved of being. We need divine guidance as we make a habit to pray. We draw nearer to God, we depend solely on Him. There should be constant prayers of thanksgiving for His goodness and love. In John 14:14, if you ask anything in my name, I will do it. Brethren, our first song is entitled The Prayer.
Thank you.
I would like to invite the congregation to please stand. And please bow your heads. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for the joy and peace you have given to us. We thank you for all the blessings that we received for the past weeks. Father, we thank you for loving us, that you bring answers in all areas of our life. Fill our heart, Lord, with the fruit of the Holy Spirit, so that we may be worthy of all the kindness you have showered upon us. Father in heaven, we invite the presence of your Holy Spirit to be with us at this moment. Lord, I pray for this church, Nordarm. May your blessings will continue to shower among members. We pray to those who are sick, to those who are suffering or sorrow. May you grant them the determination to overcome all obstacles in lives, and that easier to bear. Lord, we pray especially to that 15 years old girl that we don't know what happened now. May your healing hand will touch upon her. We know that nothing is impossible in your care. Lord, we pray for this Filipino choir, that your angels will sing with us. May the lyrics of this song will be the message to this congregation and to the community. Father, forgive us as we are sinners. We are thine. Make us, mold us, and use us, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen.
Happy Sabbath, church. Happy Sabbath, church. Thanks. My name is Bayani. I just joined this amazing group for less than 2 months now. And the first time I sang with them in a church was back at Morley. And literally after that Sabbath day, for like more or less a week, I've been singing this song, humming this song, whistling this song that you're about to hear. The title of the song is Faith to Carry On. It's lovely to hear, but the message is also beautiful. And I also like to share some of my experience, because there are times when we experience tough times and we try and solve it in our own way, you know. And in my case, I was kind of ashamed and felt hesitant to, you know, talk to God or pray to Him, because I felt like I didn't do anything in glorifying Him or do His work or even spreading His work. Spreading His word rather. But our church elder told me that it's actually the devil working. You know, the devil is trying to prevent me to talking to God or to pray to Him. But just like any father, God would love His children to talk to Him. You know, talk to Him, a prayer of thanks, or ask for forgiveness maybe, or ask for help, you know. And so I ask you today, Nordarm Church, in this beautiful Sabbath day, I ask you that listen to the music, but take it with your heart. Take this song with your heart. You know, you might be experiencing tough times as well, or you may be in the future, or even if you are not, you know. Listen to the song with your heart. Sing it, whistle it, hum it, whatever, you know. But because God is always there for you. Put your faith in God and never always forget that. Because this song will tell you why that God would love us to always, always have a joyful heart.
Thank you. Good morning, church. It's often when we're worried and anxious and overwhelmed that we cry for God to speak to us. We look for his voice for guidance when we need something. The good news is that God is always wanting to hear from us and speak to us. God is constantly speaking to people, but too often they miss out on hearing God's messages because they seek his guidance only occasionally. Usually, when they're going through a crisis or facing a major decision, then with a dire need to hear from God, people become confused, frustrated, when they don't clearly hear what they should do. They start to wonder how to hear from God and why there aren't. It doesn't have to be that way. God wants everyone to hear his messages clearly, and it's impossible to do so. The key is to forget about formulas and gimmicks for hearing from God and to focus instead on developing the kind of relationship with God that will empower you to hear God speaking regularly. The closer you get to God, the more you can enjoy ongoing conversations with him, both listening and hearing from him. The more God will use those conversations to transform you into the person he wants you to become. The next song we're going to sing, Listen With Your Heart.
Thank you. Have you been enjoying that? Awesome, what a blessing. Thank you guys for coming up. It's now time for our tithes and offerings. We invite the deacons to come up and take our tithes and offerings. Since there are quite a few, if we can have four deacons, that'd be great, but if we can't, can you please come up? Today's tithes and offerings, today's offering is for our local budget. Good, thank you.
Let's just bow our heads. Our most gracious and kind Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for all the blessings that you've given us, Lord. Thank you for your generosity, for providing us with our works. Lord, here we give to you a portion of what you've blessed us with. May you will use this, Lord, to further your work. Bless this offering that it may help you spread your gospel, Lord, here in Northam as well. Thank you for answering our prayer. Please forgive us our sins. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Hello. Music for the children. So they can actually come. Come, children, come over here, and I have a story to tell you. Come on, don't be shy, because I'm shy. Come closer, so you're near me. Are you awake? Yeah? Are you sure? Okay, let's try this. One little finger, put your finger up, come on. One little finger, one little finger, one little finger, tap, tap, tap. Point your finger up, point your finger down, point it to the door. What's a door? Point it to the light. Point it to the piano. Where's the piano? Yeah. Point it to the bull. you found the bowl. Let me get that bowl. Do you know what this type of bowl is? What is it?
A bowl.
Yes, it is a bowl. How do you use this bowl? Do you know what kind of sport this bowl is for? Football, not quite. Do you know? Basketball. Who loves to play sports here? Do you love sports? What sports do you play?
Tennis?
Tennis? Do you play anything? Do you play anything? No? Do you play any games at school?
I play tennis.
Oh, you play tennis. That's good. Yeah, I love tennis too. And actually, our choir director here, he loves tennis too. And he actually is very good at it. And, you know, I know someone as well who loves basketball. And he's actually here, and he actually owns this bowl. Come up here, please. Oh, he's here. Look, catch the bowl. Actually, this guy, can you get me the bag? I forgot to get it, sorry. This guy actually plays basketball. Do you know a famous basketball player?
Him.
Him? Oh. This is Wilmer June, but that's not Michael Jordan. He's just Wilmer June. And Wilmer June is really good at basketball, and he's got like tricks and stuff that he can show you. And this guy, actually wins a lot of awards and trophies, like this one. Do you know what this one is? A gold trophy, yeah, but this is not real gold. And he has like a shrine of them at home. And he's actually very proud of it. But, oh. But are trophies and medals, are these all important in life?
No.
No. You know, for some of us, or many of us, just like this Wilmer June guy, winning is so important in life. We like to win all the time. Do you like winning in games? You like winning in games? Yeah, I like winning in games too, and I love winning in life in general. Like, in anything, I like to win. But does God look at our wins and our losses? No, yes, he doesn't. Do you know where God looks at? Have a guess.
At the sky.
At the sky, yeah. But he actually looks at our hearts. God doesn't care how many times we've won in life or how many times we've lost. God just looks at our hearts. Do you know what he asks for in us? He asks us, am I in your heart? Is Jesus in your heart?
Jesus in our heart.
Jesus is in your heart. That's very good. So don't be just like this guy who just keeps winning stuff. And I mean, it's okay to win, but always remember to have Jesus in your heart. Okay, you may go back to your seats now. Thank you. Thank you, Wilmer June.
Gonna ride the chariot in the morning, Lord. I'm gonna Rise the child in the morning, Lord.
I'm getting ready
for the judgment day. My Lord, my Lord.
Rise
the child in the morning, Lord.
I'm gonna ride
the child in the morning, Lord.
I'm getting ready
for the judgment day. My Lord, my Lord.
Are you ready, my brother?
Oh, yes.
Are you ready for the journey?
Oh, yes.
Do you want to see my Jesus?
Oh, yes. I'm waiting for the chariot because I'm ready to go.
I'm gonna ride.
Ride the chariot in the morning, Lord.
I'm gonna ride.
Ride the chariot in the morning, Lord.
I'm getting ready
for the judgment day. My Lord, my Lord.
Are you ready, my sister?
Oh, yes.
Are you ready for the journey?
Oh, yes.
Do you want to see your Jesus?
Oh, yes. I'm waiting for the chariot because I'm ready to go.
Ride
in the chariot to see my Lord. Judgment day, my Lord, my Lord. Ride the chariot in the morning, Lord. Ride the chariot in the morning, Lord. I'm gonna ride in the chariot to see my Lord, to see my Lord.
Can the choir please come up? Can I invite the congregation to please stand and sing Great is Thy Faithfulness with us? Thank you for singing with us. Please be seated.
How can I keep from singing your praise? A song that greatly reminds us of a God, a wonderful, mightiful being, a God of love and a God who cares for everyone. But most importantly, he is a God who welcomes us all with open arms. The praises we sing every Sabbath day always gives us a message that God is always there for us. I would now just like to quote some lyrics from this song. How can I keep from singing your praise? How can I ever say enough? How amazing is your love? How can I keep from shouting your name? I know I am loved by the King and it makes my heart want to sing. This powerful song emphasizes on the idea of expressing our love to our Creator. How can I keep, this song says. How can we all stop singing his praises when God is this amazing, wonderful being? Psalm 98, verse 4 says, shout triumphantly to the Lord, all the earth. Be happy, rejoice out loud, sing your praises. In the next song, we all express our gratitude towards God, who through him makes all of our hearts want to sing. How can I keep from singing your praise?
In my soul, and I hear the music. Good morning, church. Agnus Dei. What does that mean? It's a Latin word which means Lamb of God. The Bible refers to Christ as the Lamb of God in 1 John 1:29, God's only begotten Son, the same Son which was offered as a sacrifice on our behalf. In the book Patriarchs and Prophets, chapter 4, it says, when man sinned in the Garden of Eden, man was doomed to die. But divine love had conceived a plan whereby man might be redeemed. The broken law of God demanded the life of the sinner. In all the universe, there was but one who could, in behalf of man, satisfy its claims. Since the divine love is as sacred as God himself, only one equal with God could make atonement for its transgression. None but Christ could redeem the fallen man from the curse of the law and bring him again into harmony with heaven. Christ would take upon himself the guilt and shame of sin, sin so offensive to a holy God that it must separate the Father and his Son. Christ would reach the depth of misery to rescue the ruined race. The angels prostrated themselves at the feet of their commander, Jesus Christ, and offered to become a sacrifice for man in his stead. But an angel's life could not pay the debt. Only he who created man had the power to redeem him. Only the blood of the Lamb of God is worthy to redeem the fallen race. And truly, the Lamb of God was victorious in his quest to redeem man through his blood by dying in the cross for us. Now, it is our choice to accept Christ, the Lamb of God, to live eternally with him or not. I hope you choose Christ. As the choir sing their last praise entitled Agnus Dei, contemplate on the lyrics. It says, worthy is the Lamb, the Lord Almighty.